You had this one line mm-hmm. that stood out to me. You said the landscape changed when I went against the grain. Mm-hmm. The niggas wasn't quick to embrace. Why do you think that was?
I mean, those minimalistic beats, you know what I'm saying? People listening to my production thinking like, okay, you know, some of the tracks had drums, but a lot of them didn't. They were sitting around waiting, yo, when the drums gonna come in, you know what I'm saying? Or whatever the case may be. So I think it was the minimalistic approach. A lot of people was like, you know what I'm saying? It was a little off, you know, standoffish to it.
But you said the landscape change. Do you feel like you were the catalyst for that change?
I was the catalyst. You know what I'm saying? I ain't gonna, like, it's not about my feeling. It's about the truth and the facts. Mm-hmm. Like, you know what I'm saying? If you date 10 years back, wasn't nobody doing it like this. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's 10 years ago when I made Mossberg and then Reloaded and stuff like that. So this sound was kind of like abandoned. And also I felt like you know, cavaliered, even went further. You know what I'm saying? As far as like, you know, the approach, you know what I'm saying? This approach in making music. So
I'm gonna tell you what a couple people said to the critics out there. This guy Rob Uncut does so. He said, love these Drake think pieces about how influential he is. Meanwhile, Roc Marciano dictated the sound of the last decade of underground rap. And then I got Fake Shore Drive from Chicago jumped in. He said, I said it before, I'll say it again. Roc Marci created his own genre. His fingerprints are all over the place. He deserves all the accolades and much more.
Wow.
Because now with the decade, it makes people look at it in a context. Like, do you yourself even like be like, holy shit, like, look at this. Like, because now it's like, even if you was responsible for the turn, you took it, like you said, and advanced it. So now it's in a real context of like a run and longevity in 10 years.
Mm-hmm. Who had this type of influence for 10 years, man? You'd be hard to find any artist that's 10 years in the game of making music and still making music that's relevant and people even care about their projects. You know what I'm saying? So for one, that's flattering in itself, you know, but 10, it didn't feel like 10 years though. I'll be honest, it don't feel like it. You know what I'm saying? I feel like I look younger and prettier than I did 10 years ago. So it's like, it's kind of weird, but you know what I'm saying? I take it, thank God. You know what I'm saying? You know, because I think if I was looking all crazy and washed up, it probably wouldn't be no hype behind it. They'd probably be like, this old man, if you don't get out of here, but it's a blessing, man. You know what I'm saying? That people even acknowledge it still 10 years later, man.